Welcome back. Problem 5.107. This problem is taken from chapter number 5, Analysis and Design of Beam for Bending, and book name is Mechanics of Material by Baer and Johnson, 6th edition. And the topic is Singularity Function or Michaelis Method. So statement is, in part A, we have been asked, using singularity function, write the equation for shear and bending moment for the beam and loading shown, and in part B, determine the maximum value of bending moment in the beam. So you can see this is a simply supported beam having pin support at point A and roller support at point E. There is a point load of 48 kN at B, and at C we have 60 kN, and at D we have a 60 kN load as well. So you have to determine the shear and bending moment equation for using singularity function. So let's start with the solution. The first step is that if you remove this pin support at point A, so you'll be having a reaction force which is equal to RA. And if you remove this roller support at point E, so you will be having a reaction force which is RE. So we'll find this RA and RE by using equation of equilibrium. So first equation of equilibrium is that sum of all moment about point E is equal to zero, taking the counterclockwise moment as positive. So about point E, first load is this RA into perpendicular distance. This is equal to 4.5 meters, and this is producing clockwise moment, so it will be negative. So I can write minus RA into 4.5. The second moment about point E is due to this 48 kN load, and perpendicular distance is, this is 3 meters, and it is producing counterclockwise moment, so it will be positive. So I can write 48 multiplied by 3. The third load which is producing moment about point E is 60 kN, and perpendicular distance is 1.5, and it is also producing counterclockwise moment, so it will be positive. So I can write it plus 60 into 1.5. And the last moment that is producing force which is producing moment about point E is 60 into 0.9, and it is producing clockwise moment, so it will be negative. So minus 60 into 0.9, and the sum of all moment about point E will be equal to 0. So when you solve this, you will get RA will be equal to 40 kN. Okay. Now we'll find this RE by using another equation of equilibrium, that sum of all forces along y direction must be equal to 0, and upward force is taken as positive. So starting from RA, which is plus 40, then minus 48, minus 60, minus 48, minus 60, plus 60 is plus RE is equal to 0. So you can get RE will be equal to 8 kN. Now you have both RA and RE. So what we are will do is that this is RA, which is 40 kN, and this is RE, which is 8 kN. So we will find shear force and bending moment equation by using singularity function. So we will start from the left hand side and move toward the right hand side, and at the end, at right hand side, we will neglect this 8 kN force because this will cause zero. I have solved so many problems and I have explained it. You can also try that. Now we'll move to find the shear force equation using singularity function. So we will write it, the shear force equation. As you know that all loads are point load, so we will use this figure, and we will use the shear force equation and bending moment equation is this one. So the load is downward, shear force is minus P into X minus A. So starting from the first load, which is 40 kN, that is upward. So this shear force equation for 40 kN will be positive into X minus A. Since it is starting from point A, A is equal to 0. So X minus 0 power 0. Next load is this minus 48. So I will write minus 48 into X minus A for this load is 1.5. So 1.5 power 0. For this 60 kilonewton load, I will write minus 60 into x minus, now a is this distance, which is 3 meter. So I will write x minus 3 power 0. For upward load, this will become positive. So positive 60 into x minus total load from here, distance from here to here, this is 3.6 meter. So I can write it x minus 3.6 power 0, and we will neglect 8 kilonewton load. So if we simplify it, shear force equation will be 40 into x power 0 is 1, so 40 minus 48 into x minus 1.5 power 0 minus 60 into x minus 3 power 0 plus 60 into x minus 3.6 power 0. And this equation 1 is the required shear force equation. Now for bending moment equation, bending moment equation using singularity function, we will write m of x, and again we will use now this moment equation for point load. So for this 40 kilonewton load, this will be plus p, because this is the minus p is for downward load, and plus 40, it will be plus for the upward load. So p is 40 into x minus a is 0, 1. For this 48 kilonewton load, again this will be minus 48 into x minus 1.5 power 1 plus minus 60 into x minus 3 power 1 plus up for this load plus 60, it will be x minus 3.6 power 1. So if you simplify this, this moment will be equal to 40 into x minus 48 into x minus 1.5 power 1 minus 60 into x minus 3 power 1 plus 60 into x minus 3.6 power 1. And this is equation 2, which is the required bending moment equation using singularity function. Now what we will do is that, again I will write here that now we can find moment at various point or various values of x to check at which point you can get maximum bending moment. We will first find this. For that I will need this equation m of x. I will write it over here in next page. So m of x was 40x minus 48 into x minus 1.5 power 1 minus 60 into x minus 3 power 1 plus 60 into x minus 3.6 power 1. This was the required bending moment equation. Now we will find for different value of x. At x is equal to 0, at x is equal to 1.5, at x is equal to 3.5, at x is equal to 3.6, and at x is equal to 4.5 meter. We will find the bending moment for this value. So for that I will draw a table, that is point. This is point A, this is for point B, this is for point C, D and E. Clear? So I will write it point A, B, C, D, E. And for that x distance will be in meter. So A point is at 0 meter, B point is 1.5 meter, C is 3 meter, D is 3.6 meter, and E was at a distance of 4.5 meter from point A. And we will find the moment that will be having unit kilonewton into meter. Now, if you put x is equal to 0 in this equation, there, so I will write only 1. So 40 into 0 minus 48 into 0 minus 1.5 power 1 minus 60 into 0 minus 3 power 1 plus 60 into 0 minus 3.6 power 1. So this will be 0. Clear? This will be 0. This is minus 1.5. So any negative value inside Macaulay bracket will be 0. So this will be also 0 and this will be also 0. So we will get the bending moment at point A or x is equal to 0 is 0. Now for 1.5, so 40, put in equation 2, 40 into 1.5 minus 48 into 1.5 minus 1.5, clear, power 1 plus 60 into 1.5 minus 3 power 1 plus 60 into 1.5 minus 3.6 power 1. So you can see that this value is 0. So 0 power 1 is 0. So this term will be 0. This is negative. So anything inside the negative will be 0. So this term will be 0 and this term will be 0. So we will only left 40 into 1.5, which is equal to 60 kilo Newton into meter. Okay. Now at point C, when you put this, so you will get 40 into 3 minus 48 into 3 minus 1.5 power 1. And if you put 3 in this, so this will be 0 and this will be negative term, this will be also 0. So we will get it as 48 kilonewton into meter. And for point D, if you put 40 into 3.6 minus 48 into 3.6 minus 1.5 power 1 plus 360 minus 60, sorry, not plus, this is minus 60. Minus 60 into 3.6 minus 3 power 1. And this term will be equal to 0 because 3.6 minus 3.6 is equal to 0. So we will get it 48 kilo Newton into meter. 7.2 kilo Newton into meter. And for E is equal to 4.5, when you calculate it, you will get 0. Clear? So, what we conclude is that after finding this, we found that maximum value of bending moment is at B, point B, clear, which is equal to MB, and that is maximum bending moment 60 kilonewton into meter, which is the answer of our this question. And this was all about this problem 5.107. I hope you have enjoyed this video and you have learned from it. Those who are new to my channel, then subscribe it and don't forget to press the bell icon so that you can get notification about my latest videos. If you have any question, you can ask me in comment section. Thank you for watching.